Guys, welcome back to your wine girl. So today is Tell It to Melanie Tuesday, and if you guys have been watching, every Tuesday I do whatever you guys want me to talk about. Can be about anything, but we're going to continue with video comments just because it seems like you guys like it when I talk about the video comments that you guys share with me, which I love your video comments, guys. Keep them coming. I really appreciate the support. So we're going to talk about last week's videos. Now, we did have a lot and lots of comments, which I really love, guys. Thank you so much for your support. So last week, the biggest one that I got a lot of comments on was the Manic Mommy Monday. So last week's Manic Mommy Monday was me going back to work. Which, if you guys watched the video, you know, it was hard for me. It wasn't too bad, actually, going back to work, but I think it was just kind of bad about trying to be focused and, you know, trying to be actually working and not thinking about baby, and then just, it was really intense, I guess I should say. So we're going to talk about those comments first. From Tiana Spetson, I got one saying, hope you are now at home enjoying your sweet baby. And yes, thank you, Tiana. I was so happy to get home and just hold him. I missed him all day long. From Alicia Haugen, my best friend, she said, oh, bestie, I hope you made it through okay. I know pumping was probably the hardest part for me, but I did make it work. It breaks your heart being away from them, but once you get home, the snuggles are so good. Just keep telling yourself you are doing what's best for him, even though you may not feel like it. Plus, one-on-one daddy time is important, too. Alicia, I couldn't have said it better myself. Pumping was definitely interesting to do at work. It's completely different. You know, the time crunch, trying to relax yourself, trying to think about, you know, this is the best thing, even though, you know, I really would rather be home just feeding him instead of pumping. And you know, it was really hard being away from him, but yes, the one-on-one daddy time, which he was with daddy all day while I was at work, I know that they needed it, and I'm all for daddy time, so it was a good day when I got home. One of my teammates at work, Angela, said, your team has your back, girl, you can do this. And that was so awesome to hear, Angela, Angie. Because, you know, I needed that support. I needed that coming back. And I do work with a great team. They are awesome. My mother said, hang in there. It's going to be easier as you start to adjust. And yes, you are correct, mother. And my cousin Joy said that, you know, always thought it would be an impossible step feeling for you, even though she's never been there. She's like, you're an amazing mom, and you will find a way to make it work for you and your family, and I love you, cuz. I love you too, Joy. Thank you so much. And if I gotta make it work, I'll make it work. So, thank you guys so much for those comments on that. And actually, I had one more from a kind of a coworker, Larissa Line. She said, hope you survived. As long as your baby is with someone you trust, that is the best peace of mind. Oh, and have them send lots of pictures throughout the day so you know that they are taken care of. Good luck. Thank you, Larissa. I know as a mom yourself, yes, it is tough. And I appreciate that having another mom in the work industry that the same line that I do, giving me that peace of mind. It was really nice to hear from you, Larissa. And my friend Joy says she still loves getting pics of her daughter Ariel while she's at work, and she works 12-hour shifts, so that can definitely be rough for her. After she turned two, she started going to a babysitter, and by then she was comfortable being away from her, and they still use that same babysitter now. And thank you, Joy. That was really good insight to hear from you. You know, I might do a babysitter later on, you never know, but right now it's family, and it's still going to be tough, but I'll keep that in mind on the babysitter. And yes, always yes for all of you guys for leaving comments. Oh, I got so many pictures, and I loved it and made my day, so thank you guys so much for that. And then I do have one on our Oktoberfest. I have a couple on Oktoberfest beer review. Thank you guys so much for doing that also. That was an interesting review. If you guys haven't watched it yet, that was probably the first review that I've done where I didn't really like either beer. So, yeah, that was interesting. But you guys should definitely watch it. You know, I want to hear your feedback on that still. So on the Oktoberfest beer review, between St. Arnold and Carbach, I've got from Hillbilly Wine 101 saying, nice comparison, great review. Thank you, Hillbilly Wine 101. I always like your comments, and I like how you're so positive on the videos. I also got from one of my friends at work, another co-worker, Jonathan. He just kind of made a fun comment saying, yo, did you steal that Gaylord glassware? And yes, if you guys watched the video, my little sampler glass was one that was from the Gaylord here in Grapevine, Texas. And I said, no, I did not. I actually participated in the Main Street Fest here in Grapevine, and Main Street Fest in Grapevine always have a craft beer tasting, and so they give you the little beady glasses, you know, and so they happen to be some from Gaylord. I think they were just recycling some of their glassware, so I do not steal. So thank you, Jonathan, for that, and then Bonnie Richardson, one of my favorite people who loves to comment, saying, I'm going to St. Arnold again this year. That's a good choice, Bonnie. It's a very good choice. All right, guys, so thank you so much. I hope I mentioned your comment, guys. If not, stay tuned, because, you know, every week, unless you guys want me to talk about something else, this is what I'm going to be doing, because I love reading your comments. They are so much fun, guys. I love the positive or the funny ones or just anything you guys want to say. Oh, and Beverly, I like your ones that say hello. Thank you very much. So guys, keep them coming. I really appreciate all of your support, your feedback, whether it be negative or positive or funny, or just if you want to say hello. You know, I love all of that. That gets me more notice. That gets me more motivation to keep doing this, guys. So I really, really appreciate it. So thank you for joining me on Tell It to Melanie Tuesday. And remember to keep joining me every day, guys. So tomorrow is going to be Wine Wednesday. What will it be? All right, guys. Cheers.